glamour of five stars and the cachet of a central London address don't come cheap, but then there's nothing cheap about the Hampshire. The new owners, the Edwardian Group of Hotels, have spent £25 million on this venture. So we asked Borg Elgard, an acknowledged expert on hotels, to give the Hampshire the once-over and decide if it warrants five stars and a bill of £225 a night for one of their studio suites.
And it looks like it's got the makings of a five-star hotel. Yes,
it does. What does it take to be a five-star hotel?
Well, apart from the obvious things, like the decor has to be very luxurious, the furnishings, a lot of things in the rooms which they have here, like three or four telephones, excellent bathrobes, beautiful bath linen, like little tots they have here with the beautiful slippers they have here. A lot of things, quite apart from a very, very beautiful and deluxe decor, of course, is the service in the hotel, which you can't see just by looking at the hotel.
In short, it's attention to detail and making your guests feel as special as the artifacts that brings success in the long term. Five-star hotels seem to be the coming thing, or are planned for Docklands, the old St George's Hospital site and County Hall. And it's not just a matter of glitz. The London Tourist Board have been calling for middle-price hotels, but skyrocketing land prices in prime areas of central London means going to the top end of the market is the only way to make it viable. And they'll soon find out if it is. Tricia Ingrams at the Hampshire Hotel, Thames News.